Greetings. I think it is important to understand the heart of Islam.
1,200,000,000 Muslims of the world, 100% of us, we believe that Jesus was born miraculously, that he is the Christ. He gave life back to the dead by God's permission, and he healed those born blind and the lepers by God's permission.
Deedat has just finished a great speech. He is claiming they honor Jesus the Christ. Did you notice his caveat on each of the previous statements? By God's permission.
He gave life back to the dead by God's permission, and he healed those born blind and the lepers by God's permission.
Think about that phrase, by God's permission.
He gave life back to the dead by God's permission.
He gave life back to the dead by God's permission.
And he healed those born blind and the lepers by God's permission.
And he healed those born blind and the lepers by God's permission. By God's permission. Do you know why Deedat has to say this very specific phrase? Allow me to explain it to you, Lucy. When Mohammed was alive, men challenged Mohammed. Surah 28:48. But when there came unto them the truth from our presence, they said, why is he not given the like of what was given unto Moses? Basically saying, if you are a prophet like Moses, they would say, perform miracles like Moses did. Actually, this is a very fair challenge. But it was one Muhammad could not meet.
Psst! When God did not send you, God won't work miracles to endorse you.
So what is a fast-talking, used camel-selling false prophet to do? You claim Allah does not want to work them. You claim you have no authority, which is a rare admission of truth, and that you do not have permission to work them. And to sell the con, you say all the other prophets could only work miracles by Allah's permission too. Remember, Muhammad had 23 years to think through his reasonings for his writings. In fact, the phrase, by Allah's permission, appears in some form over 40 times in the Quran. It was a bedrock in the thinking process of Muhammad. It is part of the unthinking rationale of fatalism that is the foundation of Islam. Think Inshallah. But in the case of prophets, the intent is to continue the rationale that no prophet could work a miracle by their own will. But is that true? Let's look at the prophets to see. 2 Kings 2:14. And he, Elisha, took the mantle of Elijah that fell from him, and smote the waters, and said, where is the Lord God of Elijah? And when he also had smitten the waters, they parted hither and thither, and Elisha went over. Now remember, according to Islam, Elisha needed God's permission to strike the water, and Elisha needed God's permission to taunt God with his own words. Where is the God of Elijah? I don't think so. That just makes no sense at all. What about Jesus? With a cursory, slipshod examination, there can appear to be scriptural support. After all, John 5:30 does say, taken out of context, I can of mine own self do nothing. But there are clear examples when Jesus exercised his own will to exercise his power and authority. Let's take a look at just a few such examples. Mark 11:12. And on the morrow, when they were come from Bethany, he was hungry. And seeing a fig tree afar off, having leaves, he came, if haply he might find anything thereon. And when he came to it, he found nothing but leaves, for the time of figs was not yet. And Jesus answered and said unto it, no man eat fruit of thee hereafter forever. And his disciples heard it. So what just happened here? Jesus approached a fig tree and was hungry, and finding no figs, Jesus cursed it. Mark 11:19. And when evening was come, he went out of the city, and in the morning as they passed by, they saw the fig tree dried up from the roots. And Peter, calling to remembrance, said unto him, Master, behold, the fig tree which you cursed yesterday is withered away. Now here is why this example is fresh in my mind. Recently, a MOhammedan tried to insult Jesus and claim Jesus was stupid for not knowing the time of figs was not at hand. How stupid your Jesus was to curse a fig tree just doing its job. It was not yet time to produce figs. But the MOhammedan was oblivious to some things. First of all, the fig tree died. That means Jesus' curse had authority to kill the tree and do it quickly. In fact, the very next day. So Jesus spoke with real authority, not claiming the miracles are with Allah and I don't have permission. Jesus spoke with authority. Secondly, Jesus did not say, Inshallah, if it's God's will, if it's Allah's will, then this fig tree will die. Nor did Jesus ask God to kill the fig tree. And then, I believe by the Holy Spirit, I confounded the MOhammedan. I simply asked him, did Jesus kill the fig tree, or did God? You see, if Jesus did, then Jesus spoke and cursed with authority as he willed. But if you say, by God's permission, you now call God stupid when you call Jesus stupid, because you claim God killed the fig tree wrongly when he empowered Jesus and permitted the curse and performed the curse. So Jesus killed the fig tree by his will, by his authority, or else you are calling God stupid. He had no answer. A second example Islam ignores is this. Matthew 8:2. And behold, there came a leper and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. And Jesus put forth his hand and touched him, saying, I will, be thou clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed. But wait, you say, Deedat did not ignore this. This is the leper Deedat said Jesus healed by God's permission. Notice what Jesus said and did not say. I will. Not if it is the will of Allah. Not if I have the permission of Allah. I will. And as I read this, I noticed something else. And behold, there came a leper and worshipped him. And worshipped him. Now, if you were Allah, and someone just worshipped your prophet, and asked your prophet to heal him of some disease, what would you do? Would you empower the prophet to work a miracle that only increases his stature and gives him glory? Or would you strip his power until the prophet admits he has no power? He only heals by the permission of Allah. All the miracles are with Allah. Amazingly, the man was healed at Jesus' command. So there is a real flaw in Islamic thinking which teaches the miracles are with Allah. Miracles are by Allah's permission. Because Allah evidently permitted Jesus to receive worship and still work miracles. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.